Learning your ABCs with all your buddies.
I'm Miss Jillian.
And I'm Pastor G. Jesus loves you and so do we.
Miss Jillian, do you know what elves in Santa's workshop learn in preschool?
What?
The alphabet.
Was that a joke?
Yes, or if you prefer, a jocular jest.
Well, I need to introduce today's letter. This is an uppercase J, and this is a lowercase J. J makes the J sound, like in Jaguar, or in juice.
Or jokes. I love jokes so much, I could do a little jig, or go for a joyride in a Jeep.
Let's not jump ahead of ourselves. Maybe you can tell jokes another time? We really have a lot to jam in today.
Jump at Jehoshaphat. You're right, Jillian. Although our Bible character for today is not Jehoshaphat, although it could be because he was a king of Judah.
Hooray!
But rather, Jesus. Jesus is the best Bible character of all.
Can you tell the kids why Jesus is the best Bible character?
Jesus was God's son, and he came to teach us about God and to show us God's love.
How did Jesus teach about God?
Jesus taught people to follow him around and to listen to what he said. These people who follow Jesus and listen to what he taught are called disciples. Jesus taught them about the Bible, and he taught them what was right, and he told them what was wrong.
Some of Jesus' disciples also had names that started with J, didn't they?
That's right. Jesus had disciples with names like Judas or James and John. In fact, James and John were in their fishing boat when Jesus told them, "Come follow me, and I will make you fishers of people."
Hey, the letter J kind of looks like a fish hook. But how did the disciples fish for people?
Well, Jesus wanted to teach all people about God's love and to show all people God's love. So, Jesus taught the disciples so that the disciples could teach other people. The disciples were always looking or fishing for more people to join Jesus.
And how can we be disciples?
Just like James or John. We may not see Jesus, but we can learn from him by listening to the Bible or going to church. The disciples followed Jesus all over, and we can listen to Jesus whether we're at home or at preschool or anywhere.
Now, you said Jesus not only taught people, but he also showed God's love.
That's right. Jesus often helped people who were sick or hurting. He even raised people back to life who had died. But the biggest way that Jesus shows God's love is by dying on the cross. This wasn't something Jesus had to do, but it was the only way he could save us from life's really big problems. So Jesus did it to save us.
Wow. God must really love us a lot.
Yes, he does. So keep tuning in to learn more about your alphabet and to learn more about God. Okay.
I'm Miss Jillian.
And I'm Pastor G. Jesus loves you, and so do we.